Hey, it's Laura again from the Roadside Content Team, and today I'm going to show you a really simple way to plan and organize your social media editorial schedule using Google Calendar. Success on social media is all about consistency, showing up on a regular basis with new content. You don't need huge volumes of content to be successful. Posting a few times a week, or even just once a week on a regular basis, is far more important to gaining traction, new followers, ultimately new business for your dental practice. But as a busy dental practice, even posting just a couple times a week sounds like a lot of work. And it can be if you're not strategic about it. The good news is that you can save yourself a ton of time by planning ahead, and that's where creating an editorial calendar can really help keep you organized. You can really do this process on any calendar tool, even a paper calendar, if that's how you roll. But personally, we love and use Google Calendar, so that's what I'm going to show you today. So here I am on my Google Calendar. Hopefully, you already have this set up and you're ready to go. I normally have tons of different events and stuff I plan my whole life on here, but I've gone ahead and hidden all that because you don't really need to see it. Keep it simple. I've got a nice clean calendar ready to go here to plan my social media content. So the first thing I like to do is turn on the holiday calendar. It really helps you get some context if you're planning so that, you know, you're creating posts that are relevant. If there's a major holiday coming up and you don't want to forget, it's a good idea to spark some ideas for stuff that you might want to post. So the way you do that, if it's not already set up, sometimes it is by default, you go over to your other calendars here and say plus, and then say browse calendars of interest. And then you get a bunch of different options here, holidays. If you go to regional holidays, select this. We're in the United States here, so I'm gonna find holidays in the United States, and I'll select go for it, calendar added. And then when I go back to my calendar, you'll see that major holidays are showing up here. Okay, so now we got all our holidays. You can see that those are all in there. Let's go back to today. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is set up a separate personal calendar specifically for your social media planning. So instead of putting, so we're going to go over to our other calendars here again. You're going to press the plus sign and then say create new calendar. And we're going to call this social media editorial. We're going to say create calendar. And now you see I've successfully created my social media editorial calendar and it's showing up here on my settings for my calendars. And when I go back to my main calendar, there it is. It's checkmarked so I can see it. We haven't added any events yet, so you can't see it on the actual calendar. You can also play around if you want with the different colors, like let's change this to this nice cherry blossom color. And maybe you want to change the holidays to something else. Let's change it to purple, for example. Okay, so let's say you're planning to post on social media every Tuesday and Thursday starting next week. So what you're going to do is it's September 18th, so I'm going to go to September 22nd here. I'm going to say add new event, and we're going to say social media post. And right now, I just want this to be a generic event. So I'm going to say content TBD. Now, I'm going to leave the settings to be an all-day event. If you like to schedule it down to the hour, like at 10 a.m. on Friday, you know, on the day you like to schedule it out, go ahead and set the hour for that. I'm going to just leave it as like at some point this day, do this thing. And then rather than making it a one-time event that does not repeat, I'm going to drop this down and say custom. I want it to repeat every 1 week on Tuesday and Thursday. So I'm going to check that. And it's going to go on forever and ever into infinity. You can always delete it if you decide to change it later. Then say done. And then save. And now you can see on our calendar that starting next week, every Tuesday and Thursday, we have a new event, social media post, content TBD. Okay, the next thing we need to do is go through and plan. Let's say we want to plan, let's go to today. Let's say we want to plan the next month's worth of posts. So we're going to batch those. We're going to come up with the captions and the images that we're going to post on those days ahead of time just to save ourselves some hassle and save ourselves the distraction of having to do that on the actual day every time. So what I'm going to do is go into the actual event. So let's say next week you have a team member, or it's your doctor's birthday, and you want to give them a shout out on social media. That's the content that you're going to use for that week. So let's click on this post and say edit. And we're going to go into the generic content TBD, delete that, and say Dr. Jones' birthday shout out. That's what we're going to post about next Tuesday. And I'm going to say save. And it's, Google wants to know, are you trying to update every single event on Until Affinity with Dr. Jones' birthday shout out? Definitely not. We just want it to be next Tuesday. So make sure you say just this event and say okay. And now we'll see, just next Tuesday is Dr. Jones' birthday shout out. And the rest of these are just content TBD ready for your filling out. So let's say on Friday, you're going to do some sort of happy Friday weekend plans post. And you say save, same process, just this event, and say okay. And now we have that planned out. And you do that for every single post out until how far out you want to plan for. And that's pretty much it. That's really all there is to it. Again, we love Google Calendar, but really this practice of planning your social media content can be done with any tool, even pen and paper, if that's what you're into. Happy scheduling!